It is a beautiful day outside, but you know what's more beautiful? Tiny spaceships! We reviewed new release Star Wars Armada just a couple of weeks ago. We loved it, but we didn't give it the video treatment. So to make up for that, and because the first wave of expansions has just arrived, we're going to give you a proper Let's Play with all kinds of starships and star stuff that you'd expect. So let's get the Star Wars music playing and get started. Hello, what's your name?
Hello, I'm Tim.
What tiny spaceships have you brought unto my house?
Okay, well, what we've got this sort of assault frigate thing, which is like a lumpy space potato.
What's it good at?
It's good at killing. It's got more parking spaces.
Oh no!
As well, so that'll be fun. We've got a long fella.
Okay, oh.
He's sort of doesn't really do anything. He's a bit of an all-rounder. A nippy fella, really fast, really weak. He's going to get around the back of Quinn and scare him up a lot.
Yeah, okay, that's all right. And then there's all the squadrons in the world.
Yes, X-Wings, you know about them.
Yep.
Three of them.
Okay.
This normal one, he doesn't have a name, so he's going to die quickly. Wedge.
Okay.
Luke Skywalker, you know who he is. He's like the Harry Potter of Star Wars.
Great.
Couple of B-Wings over here. B stands for bomber. This is a special one. And then an A-Wing, because I had exactly 11 points left over.
I love A-Wings so much. They're like Miami Vice speedboats in space.
Quentin, tell me about your army, please.
You're going to be attacking the fabulous space Tories of this Victory 2-class Star Destroyer. It's incredibly dangerous in the front. Really bad at the back. Don't fly behind it. I don't recommend it. It's my flagship, which means it's got Admiral Screed. He's really angry. Wolfie Laren, he's kind of competent. Some engine techs who let it actually move at all. And some XX9 turbo lasers, which are better than the XX8 turbo lasers. Not as good as the XX10. We also have this new thing in Wave 1, the Gladiator 2 class Star Destroyer. It's a Star Destroyer that's nimble. It's got loads of black short-range dangerous dice. It can attack after it moves, and it has some assault missiles, which are going to assault you missile-y. Now we've got Hal Runner, famous X-Wing pilot, and Morla Mythyl, famous X-Wing pilot. They're going to be accompanied... X-Wing, TIE Fighters.
You got this.
Basically the same thing. They're going to be accompanied by some TIE Fighters. We also have two fabulous TIE Bombers. They like to bomb, and you may have heard of this fella. He's Darth Vader. He's going to be flying around with the TIE Bombers, making sure they don't get hurt too bad.
He sounds nice.
We've proceeded to set up of obstacles and our fleets, which is a tremendously important part of Armada, but it's very boring to watch, so let's skip to the end.
I'm nervous, because we should say that these aren't our optimal Supreme Armada tactics. I told Timmy he had to field one of every ship.
Yeah.
And I always field the same three things, and so now I'm only fielding two ships. So I'm scared because I've got no ships. And Tim's...
I'm scared because I've got this rubbish ship.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to start with my Corvette, who is immediately going to issue a movement command and run the heck away from your Gladiator.
That is not something that you need to do.
So let's go right up to speed 4.
Really?
Yep.
Speed 4, the fastest speed anything can move in space.
In the world. And we're going to run all the way away. Maybe not that,
is that
much.
Is that legal? No.
That's a bit... No, it is, because I get an extra pip, because...
My God in heaven.
So he's zooming over there.
Okay, well, this is underwhelming, but my Star Destroyer is engineering, preparing for all the damage it's going to take. So maybe you can be kind and get me an engineering token while
I can do that.
How intimidated are you? I'm moving at speed 1.
Idea.
Da-da! That's all she
okay. wrote. Okay, so you're sort of playing the scared approach.
I'm playing that I'm extremely... Should we see if I'm in range of...
No. Right, next up we've got the Space Potato, who's also doing a movement Watsits. I don't know if I want to go faster or slower.
So you were moving at speed 2.
I was moving at 2.
Which would put you here?
Yeah. I'm actually going to stay at 2, but do some... hot navigation.
Some hot running away.
Yeah.
What the hell are you doing?
I don't know. No, let's do it over here.
The maneuver tool is...
fiddly.
It doesn't obey any laws of physics in our dimension. What, you're turning? You're kind of veering away.
Yeah.
Like you lost this particular game of Star Chicken.
No, look. Look how many guns are over here. Lots of guns.
So
they're going to do this, sort of something like this, and you're going to be sad.
So then it's the Gladiator. She's a gladiator.
Ada.
Okay, but she's really far away.
What we've just discovered is that the Gladiator actually issued a squadron command, which means before it does its exciting move, we check to see which squadrons are in range, which is those two. Great, and they can move and shoot, which is looking good because they can actually swoop right in there and bomb the Corvette.
I mean, yeah, but don't.
Yeah, but I'm gonna. So, he's gonna swoop in there and deliver.
No. Sure doesn't look like it's in range.
Okay, that is definitely in range though, and I guess he's gonna swoop in there. I should have moved them both. We'll pop their little hot activation tabs. Ooh. And that is one black dice. First shot of the game on the rear of the Corvette from the first one. That is a hit. I'm gonna remove your shield there. And then the other one, that is another hit. Do you want to take a damage? Oh wait, you don't have
I'll tell
a choice.
All right, yeah, take damage.
Okay, we'll deal with that. That is one damage on this fella.
All right.
The Gladiator isn't in range, but because it's the famous starship, the Demolisher Gladiator ship, it does get to shoot after it moves. And the rear is in range of its red dice. That's two red on the rear. That is appalling. Really, oh, wait, no, because Admiral Screed over on the Imperial Star Destroyer, as we spend a dice to turn that to a crit, that's one crit into the butt of the Corvette.
All right, this lanky fellow, the Nebulon, is also doing a navigation command. I'm going to get aggressive this time.
Yeah.
Go up to speed 3.
I am noticing that everything is circling the Star Destroyer, kind of like sharks, if we just get above it here.
I'm actually more scared of these, and this guy can sort of deal with them a bit, so let's go over like this.
The Nebulon rolls two dice against squadrons, so all these squadrons are going to get ripped up if they don't, for example, hide behind the Star Destroyer.
I mean, yeah, again, with the hiding.
Oh, yeah, the B-Wings are so dangerous, but also just incredibly slow. So the anti-squadron fire on that doesn't have a great range, so I guess I'm going to start pulling people like Darthing Vader out of cover. You know what, Darth? You can just fly right into that rock field there.
Oh, of course, yeah. Just from cover to cover.
Yeah, well, that's...
just hiding. He's Darth Vader.
TIE fighters are made of papier mâché.
Do you remember Darth Vader hiding in a rock in the movies?
Yes, it was a deleted scene. It was awful. I don't know what they were thinking. In case you go after the bombers, let's go and tuck those TIEs in that debris field.
All right, two can play the hiding in the rocks games. And you know who wants to fight Darth Vader? It's Luke Skywalker.
No!
In the rocks.
So we're not technically engaged, right? But we can shoot at each other with one less dice.
That's fine. And let's fly whoever this is, nameless X-Wing, over there.
Oh my god, Luke Skywalker is fighting Darth Vader.
You haven't done your blue bits. That's...
oh, my blue bits. Well, I guess you've started a scrum, haven't you?
Sure have.
Oh, I don't want those B-Wings. Those B-Wings are going to be sneaking round. Those guys have yet to fight. On the other hand, Luke Skywalker is incredibly dangerous, so let's do what TIE fighters do and just get stuck in there. Hal Runner's gonna go get stuck in, because she's pretty good. Maul Amythor is gonna fly in, and because he's engaged now with them both. Oh, come on, Mauler. Both of them take one damage, because that's Mauler's thing. He shows
fine
up and goes,
yep, okay. Gah! Let's do these little... it's very clever.
The little tabs.
Carbon wizardry.
That leaves... the little A-Wing.
Oh, he's not engaged with Luke, so he doesn't.
Is he not? Why not?
Because he's in the rocks.
Oh, son of a bitch. Meanwhile, that was a bit of tactics there.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. These guys are just going to sweep it straight in as well.
Okay, so we've got the fight. We've got the squadron on squadron. Haymaker. Finally, it's that tie. It's that tie again. No one's engaged with Luke yet. So, let's fly this...
you can't engage with Luke.
I can, because I'm no longer drawing the line through the asteroid field. It's through Luke's base. He's not hiding from this fella, you see?
Oh, because you're playing that game.
Because I'm
the
playing...
the millimetres game.
The game... well, all miniatures gaming becomes millimetres of bullshit eventually. Right. Turn one roundup. Tim and I are going to be nice, and rather than like hiding our tactics from each other, we're going to be candid so as to better teach you how Armada works. I'm going to be honest, all of your ships are heading towards this, and it's got so many upgrades on it, and my Admiral.
Yeah, it's worth a lot of points.
If I lose it, I probably lose this game. On the other hand, I'm really happy that I've already got some damage on that, and the Gladiator can continue pursuing it, because it's not slow.
Yeah, speaking of the gladiator, Quinn's is trying to beat me in my own game by flanking me around here, so I'm going to run away. This is all quite fast.
Yeah.
So if I can get away from this and just concentrate far over here, maybe I'll be okay.
That sounds good. Continuing to be kind, I'm going to talk you through my thoughts now, because I'm the first player. Tim had this last time. We're now going to flip it to blue, which is the colour all the tabs are. They're going to be orange at the end of this turn, and we flip back to orange. Love that little feature. Now, I could move this ship first, which would be nice, because then I could command all the squadrons and get the edge on that fight. However, that would also mean it's here, which means now it can get shot by everything. So instead, we're going to move Billy Gladiator first, and we're going to try and get this thing off the board, because I fancy my chances. Okay. It can move. It's going to move three, but it's navigating, so I don't have to move three. Let's click once.
If you ram me, I'm going to push you over.
There is in no way I'm going to ram you. But what I am going to do is now use all four of my black side dice on your butt.
God.
So that's four dice from the side. If I get a crit, I can use my concussion missiles and have a great time. Oh my God! Can we say I wouldn't have used Screed's ability if I'd known you had a squiggle? Because you would have... Oh no, I used it now.
Too much.
That's unbelievable. And now the Corvette's going to get away.
Okay, Space Potato senses trouble in this sort of area. He's issuing... Oh God. A squadron command.
Yeah, surprise.
So let's roll some dice. I kind of want to kill Darth Vader because that would be cool.
Yeah, I mean, that's fair.
So he can do...
Who is it? Sorry.
Everyone.
Okay.
He's got four because he's got extra parking spaces.
Oh my God. Okay, the A-Wing tabbed. He's going to attack. He has to attack. I guess he's engaged with both, yeah. So he has to attack Darth.
Okay.
Roll some dice.
That's all bad.
That was a three accuracy. All right. You're caught with the dice, Tim. This is a little condition we like to call English dice.
All right, let's shoot the regular tie with four.
Yeah, roll the dice note here on this planet. Planet dice. That's really, really, really bad. That's two damage. Can you do the two damage on that tie? Ties only have three health because they're affordable.
This guy's probably engaged as well. Oh, he's not engaged with Darth, so he's got to do this guy.
Or Maul and Mythal.
Or Maul, now I'll take this guy off.
Yeah, that does make sense. That is enough damage to absolutely shatter him.
Brilliant. Yep, engaged. So one more on your guy with scatter, who's just going to run away, as is your want. No, because I can accuracy it.
And then do one damage to him.
Do one damage.
Okay, that is Maul and Mythal made slightly less maulery. That could have gone a lot worse.
Yep.
All things considered.
I'm not that happy with that.
So now why don't you just move your Space Potato into range of my Star Destroyer?
Sure.
That would be...
Why not?
I'll get a really nice angle on this thing. Just...
Oh, God. You know what?
What?
I'm terrified.
Should we see how many dice the Star Destroyer rolls on its forward battery? That's six dice. Yeah.
I'm going to risk spending a movement to slow down.
Wow.
Only go one.
Well, at least the Gladiator has something to catch now if the Corvette runs away. Okay, let's play this fast and loose. The Star Destroyer is also doing a squadron. You and me, we're forward-thinking people, except I'm not forward-thinking enough to actually catch all three. It's only Darth and Maul and Mythal who are in trouble. Both of them, because I'm not engaged with Luke, Darth is only engaged with the A-Wing, and so is Mauler. Let's just do Darth first. That's one, two. How many dice does Darth Vader roll? I'm a Star Wars fan, I should know this. Three blue and a red, counting crits. Holy shit, that's one, two, three, four damage, which is exactly as much as the A-Wings have.
Brilliant. They still get to counter though, so if you could roll two dice for me against Darth.
Darth Vader eats two... I shouldn't roll for you. I'm going to spend one of Darth Vader's brace tokens to drop that to four. And then the A-Wing... It's not bad, is it? Darth is now no longer engaged, so could move if I wanted him to. You know what? Let's move him to here.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to run away.
No, I'll keep your X-Wings engaged. Maul and Mythal rolls three, but he can re-roll because TIE Fighters have Swarm, and I'm swarming you, and that is bollocks. That is one damage on Steven X-Wing.
I'll take it.
Now, because of your dramatic cowardly tactics... Oh, no, we are in range. I could shoot your side or your front. So let's just do some very far away damage. I'll take it. It's two damage. You could brace, I guess.
Yeah, brace.
Okay, you brace down to one damage.
All right.
Shield drops to two. Now, do I bank to the left here? I think I do. I'm going to, rather than go forward, I'm actually going to turn slightly.
Okay, this Nebulon here, in a rather optimistic mood, is concentrating fire against the Star Destroyer. So let's do that first.
Is it in range?
Yeah, long range, absolutely.
Okay, nice. Yeah.
Four dice.
Four? Oh, I forgot that the Nebulons are incredibly dangerous.
It's terrible, just all nothing.
English dice!
Brilliant.
Old English dice.
So now let's move.
This is why I play games with Tim, basically.
Where can we go?
Oh, I turn to the left and you go to the... I'll be honest, man. I don't like that you're flying that close to the Star Destroyer on the left or the right for you. This is pretty ugly.
I mean, it's not great, I'll admit. Nah, I don't like it. Don't like it. No, I do like it.
Oh my god!
Two.
We witness, man, locked in struggle with the tool. Oh, I see. So you're going to move first next turn and get the Nebulon out of trouble before it just explodes.
God, yeah. Look at that!
The Corvette is going to quickly put some fires out and then run away. So,
is it really using it? Oh, of course, because you can. It's so small, you can set the dials this turn.
So two engineering points. That's what, one shield?
Yes.
Pop it on the back. And run away four.
Wow. The traffic jam in front of the... you know, this looks worse than it is, because what you're not doing here is letting me use any of my other firing arcs on the Star Destroyer, so it can only shoot once from the front.
Yeah.
So if everything's in front of it, miraculously, you do okay. I've just realised that because Molomythal was in range of Howl Runner, he gets an extra dice on those X-Wings.
Oh, brilliant.
Which is a hit! We're not above retconning in our games. I just think it's the gentlemanly thing to do, you know? If Tim makes a mistake, then I just let him, you know? So Howl Runner on this X-Wing, so only three dice, and that is two hits on Luke Skywalker, so he can brace and take that down to...
Yeah,
so that's Howl Runner, and then these bombers, but I don't know really if they're going to do anything. They can move four. So I guess let's take this one into this asteroid field, and then... Let's take this one here, where it's nice and out of the way of your boys.
And finally, the B-Wings!
Right, very quickly, B-Wings, very slowly.
We should overlay the Benny Hill music for this bit, because they're incredibly slow and just trying to join the fight.
They'll get there.
Will they?
In
how many years will they join the fight?
Nebulon B, or whatever, yep. Squadrons, because there's an awful lot of squadrons.
Oh!
Sure are some bombers here.
Oh, this is really bad.
Let's get them over.
Tim, don't do this. No. How many shields does it have? Three, okay.
Oh, I can't shoot. I can shoot through my own things, right?
You can, but you roll one less dice, because you're obstructed.
Bollocks to that, then. Let's go over here. On your front.
Okay.
Let's say your front. That'll be nothing.
Oh, thank God.
What is with my rolling? Okay, and then Wedge or whatever his name is.
Hey, give me a nice roll here. I've got a good feeling about this.
Not Wedge, Kayan.
Kayan.
Oh my God.
You'd probably get better rolls if you remembered his name.
Yeah, he doesn't respect me, that's the problem.
He's missing out of spite. I'm really sorry about that, man.
Right, that was dreadful.
Nebulon shoots.
All right, Nebulon shoots. He'll do a side volley at your front.
That is only two dice, thankfully.
Okay.
What is that? Hitting a crit?
Hitting a crit.
I'm going to redirect to my left.
Okay, and a front volley on literally all of your things.
You are kidding.
No.
Oh my god.
So.
No.
This guy is not in cover, so let's do him first.
Oh no. Nice roll on planet dice.
Two.
Wait, which?
This guy.
Okay, he's
going to
scatter.
Oh, can he do a thing? Scatter, all right.
Scatter, everybody, scatter, Jesus.
Please use your scatter.
Oh god.
This fella up front.
Okay. When you say this fella, they have
it's
names.
Not that one.
Which guy?
So, I don't know what their names are.
Well, tell me what
Captain
they look
Picard.
Like.
All right. So now we've got an accuracy against him, which I'll stop you scattering.
Okay. So he takes one damage. This isn't funny.
Two damage.
Is he just a regular tie? He is. So he goes down to one. Oh, I was winning this fight. What happened?
This woman at the back. Only one dice for her.
Her name
sure.
is Howley Runner.
Howl Runner. One.
Oh, God. Okay, will she scatter to avoid one damage? No, she won't. She'll eat one damage.
Okay. And now I've got to move.
That was atrocious for me. I really... Nebulon The punching way above its weight.
Yeah.
Wait, yeah. You had a navigate token?
Yeah, I've got a token, I'm using it. So I don't actually crush him.
Okay.
I do crush this guy. So
that tie will get stuck into the... Oh, it's amazing how much... Okay, he'll go directly behind you. Oh, it's Hullrunner. Oh no, he'll go here because then he can move and do loads of damage.
Yep.
Okay, the Victory 2 class Star Destroyer flagship is also issuing a fleet command. People at home, Armada isn't usually just fleet, squadron battles forever. This is kind of ridiculous. Let's do Morlamithal first. So he's going to fly in, do one damage to everyone. Phew, bam. He's then going to do an attack. 3+1, because is he within range 1 of Hellrunner? He is not. So it's only 3 dice on this X-Wing with 1 hit point left. Oh no, let's attack Luke. That is absolute bollocks. Oh no, he's got swarm, so he can reroll. No!
Brilliant.
Luke Skywalker, still a dick.
I guess he used the Force?
Don't. Just don't.
Is that what they say?
Just don't. This TIE fighter will shoot this X-Wing with 1 hit point. 3 dice, +1 from Hellrunner, and he's going to try and take it off the board. Why couldn't I roll like that against Luke?
Right.
He's toast. And finally, for my last trick, who's close to death? I definitely don't want you to take Darth Vader off the... Are these guys in range? Let's just use Darth Vader against Luke, because, come on, sometimes games just give this to you. That's 3, 4, that's Darth Vader's dice pool. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 damage to Luke. Has Luke used a token yet?
No.
Okay, then that's...
He's gonna brace. Put a seatbelt on.
Turn off your seatbelt, Luke. I love that line. That's 2 damage to Luke. Ah!
Where's Luke? Oh, I've actually already flipped it. That's fine.
Do you remember that scene in Star Wars where Luke...
flipped his damage token.
Yeah, and then blew up, was killed by his dad. Spoilers.
Did you kill him?
Yeah, 2 hit points left. Start of my turn, I'm going to use this engine tech token. This is some true level jank.
All right.
And then, people at home, I'm going to toggle Wolf Jarlsson, so I then get the token back, because that's something I paid for. God. So I can recover 1 shield, which I'll do.
Was that a fun exchange for you?
That was okay.
Yeah.
3 blue, 1, 2, 3 red, all on Billy Corvette's left side. That's going to do... Ooh, that's not a bad roll. It's not bad.
All right, we roll that big 2.
Big 2 turns into a crit.
Brilliant.
So you take 2 damage on the shields, and then you take 1 damage and a crit. Allow me, Tim. That's 1 more damage, and the crit is... Compartment fire! You can't ready your defense tokens. Ah.
Oh, no.
So much damage. And then let's do just 2 red and 1 blue. On the Nebulon, because that's how I roll, on the right side. That is... Ooh, look at these rolls, Tim! They're things of beauty! That is 1, 2, 3, 4 damage on the right side of the Nebulon.
Seems good, let's brace.
Okay, that takes it down to 2 damage. You lose a shield and you take a crit. The crit in this case is... Structural damage, take another damage. Seems okay.
All right.
Finally, the Star Destroyer has to move.
I wish I'd done some damage to anything.
It's going to... Is it going to bank again? No, because then you get behind it. It'll crawl forward at a Star Destroyer E1. You can still shoot it with the B-Wings again, which is annoying.
Okay, let's move this Corvette out of the way, because this thing's have guns and it's blocking them. What's the Corvette doing? Okay.
What is it?
Squadron. I don't remember doing that.
Can anything move?
No.
Oh, that guy hasn't. Has he moved?
Yeah. Oh, no, he hasn't.
Oh,
right.
Okay.
Him then. Nice. Okay, Wedge. Wedge, what are you doing?
Does Wedge have to shoot Darth Vader because he's in, yeah.
All right,
Vader has escort.
No problem. Darth is activated, so Wedge gets 6 dice.
Oh, God.
I like this. Oh, dear.
Do I have Darth Vader still has a brace? Here we go. Darth Vader on Wedge on Darth Vader. Jesus.
That's not great. I mean, you're not doing anything. 2 damage.
That's 2 damage. How many hit points? The Darth Vader's down to 1 hit point, just like in the movies.
Okay. Let's continue running away. But first, I have to shoot, which is not the worst thing in the world. Front and side volleys on the front of your Star Destroyer.
Yeah, you got those fabulous double angles on me.
Yeah. So we got a red and 2 reds and a blue from the front on your front. That's 2 crits. I will stop you from bracing, I guess. And finally, the side volley. 1 damage.
on the, my front.
On your front.
You can. I'll eat that like the pointy triangle I am.
Okay, and now I will continue moving really fast away from
exactly
you.
How far away is it going now?
Let's slow down to three.
Oh, are you parking on the space station?
Yeah, I've got one more token.
We've literally never done this in about five games of Armada. No one's successfully landed on a space station when they're damaged, but Tim now can discard one, like his fire.
There we go.
Jesus.
That was a space station made of water.
The Gladiator's really simple because it is just a simple creature. It's moving, but first it can shoot. It can shoot nothing of relevance. So let's gonna move it. Let's gonna move it. Which is the name of my new house music album. Blank, click, click. But because I am navigating, I can turn that into something more serious. Ooh, let's get right up behind Mr. Potato Head.
Wow, this has never happened to me before.
What, been flanked?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's awful. Okay, then I'm going to do a side volley on you, which is short range, on your butt. Let's see if I can use those assault missiles that I paid for that I can't use. That is not a crit, but I could spend one to get a crit. That kind of makes sense. What do you have?
Everything.
You have brace, evade. Well, you can't evade, so you could brace. I could turn that into a crit, then you'd have to redirect. This is rubbish, I didn't get the crit, so I'll leave it as four hits.
Alright, two hits, I'll brace.
Two hits, brace. That drops down to no shields at all, mister. The only squadrons that haven't moved are my TIE bombers and stuff, so let's do this really quickly.
Hang on. I haven't done my potato yet.
You haven't done the most dangerous ship on the board yet. That would explain why
you're a bit happy.
All of my stuff is undamaged at present.
Right, my space potato is issuing a squadron command, but you've killed everything, so that's brilliant. So we'll ignore that, and I'll do some shooting. Right, what can I see? Let's do the side first. Three
hits. Do I have any defense tokens left? Three hits. I actually brace it down to two, and then I take them on the chin.
Okay, and finally the front volley. That's two. So
all of my defense tokens are exhausted, so I will just take that. Am I going to take that two damage?
I'd say so. Let me hit some hot damage on you.
Okay, all right, fine. Ow.
Let's do a hot... No, let's stay at this angle.
I can't tell you how much I'm looking forward to go first next turn. Oh, you're so slow. Oh, it's so beautiful.
Okay.
So, your admiral is on the Star Potato, right?
No.
Where is he?
Yes.
Okay. Some cheeky bombers. These bombers are going to be straight up cheeky and attack the Nebulon on the side. I'm going to say I can do that because I have an internet TV show. And I'm going to do one hit of damage to it.
Sure. On the side?
On the side with no shields.
Oh, brilliant. One damage then.
They're going to soar all the way at speed forward to just in front of your potato. Thanks. That's okay. Cooperation. And then finally, these TIEs are not engaged with anyone. So if Halwana goes and engages the B-Wings, she's just going to get shot. So let's have a cheeky engagement with these X-Wings.
A cheeky little engagement.
There's a word for this in French.
Cluster.
That's exactly the word I was going to say. I'm relatively confident.
Yeah, I'm terrified. This all happened and I rolled very badly.
Yeah, no, that was ugly. And now the situation you're in, like if you'd gotten the Star Destroyer off the board or something, but now you're in a situation where I could, this is the dream, you know, like I can choose whatever arcs I want. The squadrons are soon going to finish cleaning up and then...
Yeah, I mean, you are forgetting about this space hospital, which I'm going to make excellent use of.
We are moving. That's not a squadron command.
Yeah.
At all. And then shooting. And this is a really hard call. So this has two damage, but isn't going to do much damage to me. This is... Okay, I'm not going to take this off the board, probably, because it's too tough and too slow. So I guess I'm going to hit the Nebulon before it can just do awful, awful, awful shit to me. Close range from my side to your side. That is... Basically, you take a crit. And if you spend a brace.
I've got no shields. All right. Let's do it.
Structural damage and you blow up. Where is the deck? I thought you were getting the card. Targeted disruption. You can't resolve critical effects. Then I guess it's my front. Because how often do you get to roll this many dice? I'm going to roll these dice from my front to your left flank, which has two shields, and I'm going to do this much damage. Seems bad. I'm going to use the Admiral's ability to turn that and spend that into a... Oh, no, I've already used the Admiral's ability! Gah! So that's just two damage that you could push from your side to your front.
Bear, do you mind?
Nope. Okay, so I can't complete that maneuver, so my speed temporarily drops to zero, and both you and me both take a damage card.
Brilliant. So just...
That thing sure is stuck there.
Nebulon first. It unfortunately is not, absolutely not, a squadron command. It's a concentrate fire command.
It's not bad.
No, it's not awful. I can hit these three on my side volley, so I'll definitely do that. Right, I'm going to roll three dice on Darth.
Darth is going to join Luke in heaven.
Yeah.
Is there a hit?
Yeah.
Is there a hit? Oh, God.
Brilliant.
I'll scatter.
All right. And then one on your guy in there, because he's in cover.
He's not, because you can... Oh, no, you can't trade line of sight.
He's dead anyway.
Oh, son of a bitch!
Let's still use the back, because I can shoot your bombers and this woman. So, two dice on her.
Is that Hellrunner? She has a name. And she'll scatter.
And scatter. All right.
Her name is Sally Scatter.
And then on the bombers.
That is one damage, so they take one damage. Bombers are pretty tough, man. If I don't get you this sodding ship with one hit point left off the board, I'm going to be monumentally upset.
This.
Oh, you're going to get away! Okay, the Gladiator is squadron commanding, weirdly.
Oh, well done.
It has a squadron. I know, right? It has a squadron of two. The only fellas in range are Hellrunner and Maul of Mythol, so they're going to have a pop. Hellrunner's going to roll three dice against... Is it Dutch? Is it Wegs? Wegs? Is it Budge? Is it... It's three dice, and it's not very good. She's got Swarm. She'll re-roll the crit to be an accuracy, so I'll use both accuracies, so you have to take the one damage, which is what was going to happen anyway. That was dumb.
Brilliant.
And then Maul of Mythol is going to roll an extra dice, because Hellrunner says, roll an extra dice, and he says, okay, and he rolls... Pretty poor. Oh, you swarm to reroll this. Oh, come on. Another all the damage, accuracy right. To do one damage. That's upsetting.
Taking it for the team, Wedge.
Right, so this thing on the potato. Two blacks, two reds on the rear. Give me the crit that I so need. You have no shields on your back, so I guess... Oh, have you braced already?
I'm tempted to burn the brace forever not to take four damage. I'm going to... lose this redirect forever to take three on my right side.
Okay.
And one crit.
The crit is structural damage.
Brilliant.
One more damage.
Good at this rolling, Lark, aren't you?
I'll try and execute the forward maneuver. I'll go one, I can't go two, and the Gladiator and the potato both take a damage.
Thanks, Quinns. But let's start with my space potato. Who is not squadrons. Concentrate fire.
That's not bad, man. You still have the double.
Yeah, we know from last time I can do both. Let's concentrate the front to two reds. Three reds.
I will... How much damage? Hitting a crit.
Hitting a crit.
I will burn the redirect forever to drop that down to my side.
Cool. Let's do the side. On your front.
Four damage and an accuracy. Oh, good lord. Okay, I'll burn the redirect. Do I have a shield to redirect it to?
One.
Two and a crit, really?
Yep.
Structural damage.
Yay!
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Seven.
And the B-Wings are going to finish it off.
Yep, that's correct.
This has not worked out well for
I'm
me.
I'm still going one. Let's go. A lovely one. Just him left.
Oh, this is awful.
All right, you know what he's doing.
This is the end of the world.
Squadrons!
Okay.
You can only do one, but...
Something tells me those B-Wings...
Wedge rolls two blacks, and I can re-roll because you've got no shields. So, let's bomb. That's good. Not re-rolling.
That is a hit, and a hit, and a crit, and a...
Oh, yes!
Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, God!
Now, this is looking better now.
Yeah, that... Should we just... So, that's... We'll flip that, and we'll flip that, and then we'll flip these, and then we'll flip this.
Okay, my Corvette has to continue moving at a ludicrous pace.
How fast is it moving?
It's moving four still. Let's see if I can't, like, spin all the way around. Oh, God.
Wow.
Wow.
I've realised in the most exciting turn of the game yet, if this bomber, which you flew past, can actually do one damage, it gets one dice, and on a hit or a crit, which is 3 out of 4, I take out the Nebulon. Which is pretty exciting, frankly. Yes!
There's nothing I can do.
You were so close to getting away with one hit point. Who's he going to attack? I'll roll for you.
Who has used their...
But all scatter. Of them. Oh, scatter? Hal... Apparently, Hal Run has used her scatter.
Yeah, okay. Let's roll 6 blues then.
This isn't funny, Tim.
Can you roll 6 damage to yourself?
I don't want to roll damage against Hal Run it myself. 3 damage. 2 accuracy, so she can't defend. She has 3 hit points, so that's 2, 1. I can't work out these maths, man. I think she's still alive. I think she's alive, but probably like on 1 hit point.
Because it's confusing.
No, I think she's still probably.
Well, so just.
So as we roll into turn 5 of 6, so these are the last 2 dials I will ever place. What have we got here? We basically got in a situation I wasn't expecting. Some dregs fighting here. And this enormous, beautiful, expensive ship fleeing from this cheapo. And then this guy, I mean, let's be honest, he's basically out of the game. He has 2 hit points left. And he's like, we can basically ignore him.
Now let's do the potato. Concentrate fire. Okay, I like that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I was not expecting you to win the squadron battle.
Gonna concentrate over here. The bombers. 2.
They have no defense whatsoever, so they go from 4 to 2.
Okay.
Fragment of their former selves.
And then just 2 reds on your gladiator. That's 3.
Ooh, scatter, obviously. Wait, oh, the gladiator.
Gladiator.
Oh, the gladiator, what can it do? It can, that's close range. It will, what's its right shields?
2.
Okay, I'll redirect 2 of those and take 1 on the chin.
And then I'm speeding up.
When you say speeding.
It's enough.
You son of a gun. I cannot believe you've used the space hospital not once, but twice.
I know, we never usually do this, so I lose the damage, right?
Yep.
Is it in range? Okay, the front volley is in range. That's 2 red dice on your butt with no shields. Sniping, that is 2 damage.
I will avoid the double dice, I guess.
If I do this, can I shoot you with my side? What do we think? This is actually what Armada is. I can just clip this rear and do it in short range. So I'll do that.
It'll mean you get a shot on me with the B-wings, both of them. But it does mean I get the full 4 black dice. See if I can kill you. That is really not very good. I'll use my... Oh, my Admiral's dead! Oh! Can't use the Admiral. This is why no one uses missiles in X-Wing, because they're so expensive and then you don't get to use them and then you go, argh! So that's 3 damage. 1, 2 more damage, so you're back down to only having 1 hit point left. And I get upset.
He's issuing a navigate command, which gives me some leeway to hopefully stay on the board. What would I like to do? If I go one,
you can always drop your speed, right? One. How fast is it going? Wow.
Right, so... That's not going to keep me on the board. What about...
That's fine.
No, that's not allowed.
So what speed are you moving?
Well, I could get... I'm moving 3. I can move up or down.
So you could drop down to 2.
That seems... Dropping down to 2 seems the best thing to do.
That was the space equivalent of a handbrake turn to stay on the board and get back in the fight.
The weird thing about Armada space is that there's an edge to it, and yeah. It's just over there.
If you imagine this, this is kind of the waterfall of space, where space runs off the world.
Okay, let's get Wedge on these bombers.
Zip.
4 dice. Oh my god.
That is 1 hit?
Just 1, yeah. Okay. So let's just do a bomber on a gladiator. 1.
Okay. You know, people on the internet are going to flip their shit that you pick the ship up.
It's fine. Fly loose. That's what they say, don't they?
Fly casual. Fly loose implies like
that's different, yeah.
Sexual promiscuity.
We could do that too.
From the X-Wing community. You are engaged with this fella, so that means he gets his extra dice from Swarm. Come on, little Ty. I need some of those blue dice you're hoarding.
How many?
2.
Ah! Wow.
Shit me. He's got...
I can brace, but it's not good enough.
Oh, no way! I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, apparently you can roll. And finally, this.
Oh my god! I have bombers! What are you guys doing? I genuinely didn't think that these were a thing. Let's fly them into... Let's do their level best to go somewhere where you would fly into their path and then they can shoot you. Squadrons without squadron commands are the worst units in Armada.
Yep.
So I'm going to do that side to back action that I crave with the gladiator. Oh, what's the gladiator doing? He's navigating, isn't he? Yeah, because that's all he ever does. Give me the crit! Give me the crit!
You don't need a crit.
Oh, have you blown up?
I'm pretty sure I'm dead.
I just want to use the concussion missile.
Yeah. Speed the heck up.
You're back to moving speed 4.
3.
We've never had a car chase in Armada before.
Is that...
Oh, you've... No! You've... No!
That's all I cared about.
Yeah, well, you succeeded. Yeah. We're going to play the X-Wing Armada game... That is bad. At the end of the game, all the damaged squadrons fly away because they don't want to be finished for the point value.
At this point, we had no more ships that were going to die, so we began the end game of Armada, tallying up how many points of ships your opponent has blown up.
Okay, should you do the thing?
You'll say a digit at a time. Okay. Two.
Oh. One. 193.
222.
Boom!
Well done.
I don't know, man. That was a sloppy game.
Thank you. Cool.
One of those.